Hi everyone, welcome to this tutorial on how to get started with the .NET MAUI text input layout control. The text input layout is a container control, which allows to add various features, such as floating labels, password toggle icons to show or hide passwords, leading and trailing icons, and assistive labels like error messages and help text on top of input controls. I will show you how easy it is to add the text input layout to a .NET MAUI application and few of the control's basic features. Before you begin, make sure you have installed the latest version of Visual Studio 2022 with the required .NET MAUI workload. You should also have one of the .NET SDKs installed on your machine. Once you have installed the necessary tools, launch Visual Studio 2022 and click Create a New Project from the dashboard. From the list of project templates, select the .NET MAUI application and provide a project name and location. Here, I'll proceed to create the project with the .NET 7.0 framework. Now the project is ready. Before I move forward, let's take a quick detour to set up the environment for running our application. Here, I choose an Android emulator. For this demonstration, I will select the Pixel 5 Android emulator. Once the emulator is selected, I'll run the application and show you the default output. The application has started compiling the default code, so let's wait for a few seconds. And now the application's homepage is displayed. Next, I will demonstrate how to incorporate a Syncfusion.NET MAUI text input layout into this application. I open the NuGet package manager. Search for the Syncfusion MAUI core package. And install it in my application. It will take a few seconds to complete the installation. Once the package is installed, I need to register the Syncfusion core handler to map the cross-platform API to the native Vue API. So, open the MAUI program file and add Syncfusion MAUI core hosting. Then register the handler by adding the configure Syncfusion core method. To use the Syncfusion MAUI controls, it's necessary to register a trial license key. I can do this by opening the app.xaml.cs file. Add the register license method and enter the trial license key. To find out where to generate the trial license key, you'll find a link to instructions in the description below. Next, I navigate to the main XAML page and remove the default scroll view related code. Then I import the Syncfusion MAUI core namespace. Now, initialize the control by adding the SF text input layout tag. As I said earlier, this is a container control, so need to add any input view control, such as entry or editor, or the Syncfusion autocomplete and combo box. Here I add the entry control. To learn about other controls, please refer to the documentation link shared in the description below. To show the floating label, just add the hint property and set its value to password. Since this is an input view control, I add a vertical stack layout as parent layout. And set the vertical options to center. And I also add the custom width to the input layout. Then I press the F5 key to run this application. a basic text input layout is rendered. When control is focused, the label will be moved to the top position. If you always need to show the hint at the top position, enable the isHintAlwaysFloated property. And now the hint will always be shown at the top. Next, I will show you how to toggle the visibility of characters in the input. To do that, add the Enable Password Visibility Toggle property and set its value to true. See here, I can show or hide the password entered by clicking this. This feature can be enabled only for the entry control. So far, I have showed the default filled container type. The background of the input view will be filled with the container color, and its stroke color and thickness will be changed based on its states. The other container types are outlined and none. To have an outline container, just set the container type property and set its value to outlined. See, the input container will have rounded corners. I can also customize the corner radius. To do that, include the outline corner radius and set its value to 8. As the name indicates, this property will be only applicable to the outline container. Then customize the padding by adding the input view padding property and set the top and bottom padding to 5. Checking now, corner radius is customized. Padding is applied to the top and bottom. Before moving to the next type, I remove the properties related to outline container. I change the container type property to none. And now the container will have an empty background and enough spacing. Finally, I'm going to show you how to provide additional information about the text entered in the input. To do that, add the helper text property and set a hint like enter your password. See now, the helper text is displayed in the text input layout control. If you need to show an error for an invalid password, you have to handle it at the application level. I just add the error text property and set its value to invalid password. To show this error, I add another property hasError and set its value to true. Here, the error is shown for an invalid password. Let me quickly summarize what we have seen. I have shown you how to create a .NET MAUI application and add the Syncfusion MAUI text input layout control with a few of its basic features. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. I've also shared a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, giving you a free license key to use our .NET MAUI products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.